Hello and welcome back to our channel, guys. And today we are breaking down an extraordinary clash in the UEFA Euros 2024, in which Spain defeated Croatia by 3-0. This match wasn't just about the result, it signified a potential shift in Spain's footballing philosophy, moving beyond the classic tiki-taka to a more direct and incisive approach. So before we dive in, make sure to hit the like and subscribe button and ring the bell icon for all the latest football updates. Now let's get into the action. Spain head coach Luis de la Fuente played this game with a 4-3-3 formation, in which he started Unai Simon at goal, Dani Carvajal at right back, Lenormand and Nacho were the two center backs, and Cucurella played this game at left back. In midfield, Rodri played this game alongside Pedri and Fabian Ruiz, while in attack, Lamine Yamal started this game at right wing, Nico Williams at left wing and Alvaro Morata played this game as a center forward. While Croatia head coach Zlatko Dalic also played this game with a 4-3-3 formation, in which he started Livakovic at goal, Stanisic at right back, Sotalo and Pongracic were the two center backs, and Gvardiol played this game at left back. In midfield, Brozovic started this game alongside Modric and Kovacic, while in attack, Maier started this game at right wing, Kramaric at left wing, and Budimir played this game as a center forward. So guys, in a match that heralded a new era for Spanish football, Spain dismantled Croatia with a stunning 3-0 victory, signaling a shift from their traditional tiki-taka style. For the first time in 137 games, Spain did not complete as many passes as their opponents, and they couldn't be happier. The last time they ceded the majority of possession was the final of Euro 2008, when they beat Germany to begin their greatest generation. Now, with no players left from that iconic team and the youngest footballer in the competition, Lamine Yamal, dazzling on the wing, Spain defeated Croatia with a display that could lead them back to glory. This was a new beginning, a new generation. While it would be premature to rule out another false dawn, this performance was impressive, fast, incisive and effective. Spain opened the group of death with a flash of life, with Alvaro Morata, Fabian Ruiz and Dani Carvajal scoring to secure a 3-0 victory before halftime, reinforcing the belief that they might be heading in a different direction. As it turned out, Spain didn't mind either. This is a team built for speed, capable of unleashing quick lethal attacks. When Croatia began to play, Spain became more effective. The first hint of this came when Marc Cucurella's long ball almost set Lamine Yamal free, but he couldn't finish. Then after Ante Budimir narrowly missed a chance, Spain struck. Marc Cucurella reached a loose ball, Rodri passed it off and Ruiz set Morata through, who finished neatly past Dominik Livakovic. It all happened so fast. An equalizer nearly came immediately, with Unai Simon saving from Mateo Kovacic, but Spain doubled their lead just as quickly. Another long diagonal into space found Lamine Yamal, and although he lost the ball, it was quickly recovered. Pedri found Fabian Ruiz, who turned and shot superbly into the bottom corner. Croatia almost responded again, with Simon making a stunning save for Marcelo Brozovic and Lovro Majer hitting the side netting with a rebound. Soon after, another great chance for Croatia went begging when Josko Gvardiol's ball across goal somehow evaded Budimir. At this point, Croatia had more possession and more shots, but Spain had the lead, which grew larger before halftime. Lamine Yamal's brilliant cross was volleyed in by Dani Carvajal, sliding in like a striker. Lamine Yamal alone inside the area might have made it 4, only to be denied by an excellent Livakovic save. At the other end, Cucurella made an exceptional block on Josip Stanisic, and Unai Simon punched away Budimir's header. Croatia might have wondered how Spain had scored 3. They certainly might have wondered how they had not scored any. Soon there were oles from the Spain fans as they kept the ball, but that hadn't been the story of the game. The answer, or part of it, was in the outstanding runs from Lamine Yamal, leaving players in his wake as he surged forward. The game was only an hour in and Spain would defend when needed, but the result was virtually sealed. However, there was a reminder of the potential pitfalls when Simon lost the ball trying to play out and Rodri brought down Bruno Petkovic, who was about to score in an open goal. Unai Simon saved Petkovic's penalty, but Ivan Perisic's encroachment nullified the rebound goal. Ultimately, Spain had moved too fast for Croatia, and that was a promising start, hinting at a different, more dynamic future for La Roja. So guys, before heading towards the conclusion, let's take a look at the match stats. Spain took a total of 11 shots in which 5 of them were on target, while Croatia took a total of 16 shots in which only 5 of them were on target. Spain had 46% of possession, while Croatia had 54% of possession. Spain completed 457 passes, while Croatia completed a total of 518 passes. Spain had 83% passing accuracy, while Croatia had 88% passing accuracy. Spain committed 14 fouls, while Croatia committed 13 fouls. Spain got 1 yellow card, while Croatia didn't got any yellow card. So guys, this performance marks a potential turning point for Spain, showcasing a new approach that balances their possession-based routes with a more direct, purposeful attacks. The victory over Croatia is not just a win, it's a statement that this new generation might be ready to carve out its own legacy. As they continue in this competition, it will be fascinating to see if this blend of old and new styles can bring Spain back to the pinnacle of international football. So that's all for today guys. What did you think of the match? Do you believe this new direction can lead Spain to glory once again? Let us know your thoughts in the comment section down below. And don't forget to like this video if you enjoyed our breakdown and subscribe for more in-depth football content. We will meet you until next time. Thanks for watching, and as always, see you in the next video.